starts right now.
Happy Saturday, everyone. We are taking a look at live cam to start your month of April. All right, April 1st, Sarah.
April Fool's Day.
Cannot believe that. Yes.
Okay, I am not a big April Fool's Day person. Mm-hmm. I don't like it when people play me, you know what I mean?
Yes.
You know?
The pranks.
The pranks.
Not a fan of them.
I'm gullible. I scare easily. I don't like it.
Well, at least you're honest about that. Yeah.
So no pranks, thank you.
Yeah, keep it easy. Take it easy on Sarah today.
Please.
<Yeah.
laughs> Well, welcome, RJ.
Yeah, great to be here. Glad to be here. Sitting in for Max today. I know Max is out in the Bay Area enjoying his time.
Very jealous.
Having a good time. A little jealous of Max out there.
And Sarah Spivey's in New Orleans, but we're joined with Mia and, no April Fool's jokes. No rain, right?
Is the weather gonna be
messing with us?
So
we've got just very, very stray chances this weekend for maybe a stray rumble of thunder. I think tomorrow morning would be the best chance to find a few showers out there, but coverage is expected to be pretty limited. No April Fool's joke today in terms of the weather, though. We've got lower humidity that is moving into at least parts of our area. That is going to make for a relatively nice start to the weekend in and around San Antonio today. So we had a weak cold front move through overnight that is still trying to inch its way farther off through our southern counties early this morning. But because of that, temperatures behind that boundary a bit cooler this morning as well. 56 is where we sit officially over at the airport here in San Antonio. 46 up in Bernie this 6 a.m. hour. A little chilly up in the hill country, both Kerrville and Comfort checking in at 44. But of course, the farther south that you go where that front is trying to move a little bit farther your way, a little warmer, 67 in Gonzales, currently 70 degrees over in Pleasanton right now. And that's also where we still have some higher dew points. The moisture is still there as well. So we have seen a little bit of patchy fog develop across our southeastern counties, really the coastal plains. That could slow some of us down out there on the roadways for any early Saturday morning plans. But here in San Antonio, points off to the north and the west, that lower humidity is now in place. And that's going to make it feel pretty comfortable throughout the first half of the weekend. A mix of sun and clouds expected this Saturday. Temperatures on the warmer side will warm into the low 80s by lunchtime, and then mid 80s are expected this afternoon. East northeast wind at about 5 to 15 miles per hour. The humidity is going to return for pretty much everybody throughout the day on Sunday. So temperatures are a little bit warmer. Again, a few isolated showers possible in the morning to a stray rumble. Monday and Tuesday, though, check out that warming trend. A taste of summer on the horizon. Low 90s by Monday, mid 90s by Tuesday, currently expected, potentially challenging a current record high before we start to see some more rain chances move in late next week. We'll get you all those details and time that out coming up in just a few minutes, guys. Mia, thank you. Pope Francis has been discharged from the Rome hospital where he was being treated for bronchitis. As he left the hospital, he told reporters, quote, I'm still alive.
That's right. The Vatican has said that Pope Francis will be at St. Peter's Square for Palm Sunday Mass to mark the start of Holy Week. 8 people are in jail and deadly drugs are off the streets after a major drug bust in New Braunfels.
New Braunfels police say after raiding 2 homes, they recovered around 6,500 counterfeit Percocet pills laced with fentanyl. Alyssa Cole joins us live in studio with the latest. Good morning, Alyssa.
Yes, RJ, Sarah, good morning. Police say all of what they seized would be about worth $195,000 on the streets. Take a look at your screen right now. They found about $22,000 in cash of handguns, assault rifles, marijuana edibles, and other narcotics. The suspects arrested are in the age range between 17 and 39 years old. RJ, Sarah.
Thank you, Alyssa. Well, speaking of fentanyl, there's so much you should know about the drug, how it affects your body, how you can get your hands on a life-saving treatment to stop someone from overdosing. You can scan this QR code and we'll take you to our website where you'll see a bunch of stories from our new series, Fighting Fentanyl. And 2 people are in the hospital this morning after a shooting on the city's south side. This happened yesterday afternoon near an apartment complex on West Amber Street near Pleasanton Road. San Antonio police say an argument between 2 groups of people, and as one group was leaving, shots were fired towards the other group's vehicle, hitting 2 people inside of it. Those 2 shot are expected to be okay. The other 2 are in jail.
A 19-year-old man named Mauricio Chavez Valderas is now in jail and facing charges for aggravated robbery. The Bexar County Sheriff's Office says he's the man who was seen leaving a McDonald's restaurant on Wednesday after he robbed three teens inside. Deputies found Valderas yesterday at a hotel on Southwest Loop 410. Another deadly night of weather in the nation's midsection, just a week after a catastrophic tornado claimed more than two dozen lives in Mississippi.
Multiple states affected, with Arkansas particularly hit hard around Little Rock and Wynn. ABC's Derek Dennis has this story about the widespread damage.
Widespread damage throughout the nation's midsection. Officials in Arkansas confirming several deaths and more than 50 people in Pulaski County hospitalized. The town of Wynn hit particularly hard.
I'm speechless. It's no words. We can't say nothing. This never happened down here like this.
It's scary. It's real scary. And all the people down that way, we just don't know if they're okay or not.
Arkansas Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders declaring a state of emergency.
Most of you know we activated Arkansas's National Guard, and we have approximately 100 guardsmen that are on the ground.
More damage centered in West Little Rock, where both commercial buildings and homes have been destroyed. Cars flipped over, leaving down trees and power lines. A meteorologist at the ABC affiliate on air in Little Rock reacting to the damage as they provided live reports.
We have friends and family who have been affected by this, that homes have been destroyed. And so if there's hesitation, we're trying to keep our composure too.
Storms also hit further north. A shelter in place at O'Hare International Airport in Chicago as the storms move through. A theater roof collapsing in Belvedere, Illinois during a concert with roughly 260 people inside.
There were multiple injuries. There was a fatality. And there was 28 persons transported by ambulance from here.
At least 43 tornadoes reported in six states, including this one near Harper, Iowa.
Advise me if I'm going to hit anything. Be my eyes, please. Be my eyes.
The storm system now moving east with severe conditions possible for major cities, including Philadelphia, New York, and Boston. Derek Dennis, ABC News, New York.
Donald Trump's campaign says it has raised more than $4 million in the past 24 hours since his indictment was announced. According to a statement released on Friday, the average donation was $34, and more than 25% of donations came from first-time donors. Thursday's historic indictment marks the first time in U.S. history that a current or former president has faced criminal charges. On Tuesday afternoon, Trump is expected to appear before a Manhattan judge to be arraigned, according to sources.
FBI agents seized more than 4,400 pounds of illegal drugs in a drug raid happening in Southern California. Authorities found methamphetamines, bath salts, and counterfeit Xanax. Some of the drugs were packaged for distribution. Agents also found raw ingredients. Experts on the scene say it was one of the biggest drug labs they'd ever seen. The raid happened Tuesday in Garden Grove, just south of Los Angeles.
A federal judge issued an order Friday that prevents Tennessee from enforcing a ban on public drag shows. The ruling comes just hours before the new law was set to take effect. The judge delayed enforcement for at least 14 days as he considers whether the ban is unconstitutional. The new law bans adult cabaret entertainment on public property, specifically including male or female impersonators or anywhere in Tennessee that could be within sight of kids. All right, time now is, what are we looking at? 6:09, starting off our Saturday morning here. Temperature is at 58 degrees.
All right, still ahead, we get a preview of a place where you can have some brisket, maybe some mac and cheese. Ugh, looks so good. That's all in today's Texas Eats.
And we'll also take a look at some of the latest trending stories right there on KSAT.com.
58 degrees at 6:09. Mia Montgomery is in for Sarah Spivey this morning, and she'll tell us what our weekend forecast is and if we can actually expect some rain or maybe not.
Welcome back to Good Morning San Antonio. The owners of a Dairy Queen in Phoenix are left with a lot of questions today after the giant red spoon outside their restaurant was stolen. Cannot believe this. Surveillance video caught two people taking off with it. The restaurant owners are also trying to get creative about the spoon swipe. Staff at the restaurant are wearing "Where's my spoon?" t-shirts.
Love that. Nice. Yeah. Love that for them.
The reward for the spoon's return: one Blizzard treat for every flavor on the summer menu. Return that spoon there.
Let's get that spoon back. Okay. This is a story out of a movie. A young Labrador named Lucky, safe this morning after being trapped on an active railroad track, unable to free himself. A San Antonio Animal Care Services officer spotted the dog lying on the tracks as he heard the train approaching. He quickly worked to get that dog off the track safely. It's unclear if Lucky's leash was caught on a nail or someone purposely secured the dog onto the tracks. I hope not. The pup is now looking for a forever home and is available at the ACS shelter.
All right, good for that individual taking care of Lucky there. So this summer is something that you've maybe never seen before at the San Marcos River. Crystal Kayak Glow Tours is going to have adventurers down the San Marcos River for a unique night of a paddling experience. So each kayak has special underwater LED lights, and the translucent hull acts as a magnifying glass, allowing paddlers to see the fish and wildlife in the river below. Trips typically take around 75 to 90 minutes, so about an hour and a half there, and you can read more about this on KSAT.com.
At first, cool. I thought it was like, oh, do they have that cool, like, you know, the algae that gets in the water glows?
Yes, where it is, it's bright. Like, you can see.
Right. I think that maybe is more in the ocean. I don't know.
Yeah.
I've watched too many, like, Instagram videos.
Discovery Channel or
something
like that.
I've also seen, like, you know, with the clear and the transparent kayaks, people take those out into the ocean, too. I think I could do the river, but I don't know if I could do that in the ocean. I'm scared I would see a big whale or something.
A shark
terrifying.
Or something like that, a tiger shark.
I would love it.
Yeah, that probably scares
Sarah's like, sign me up.
Yes.
Sign me up, please. Yeah. Sign me up for today's weather.
Because,
yes, the lower humidity moving in today for most of us is going to make for a very nice start to the weekend in and around San Antonio. So lower humidity, one of the themes of this Saturday. Highs still a little bit warmer this afternoon in the mid-80s. We'll see a mix of sunshine and clouds out there today as well. Into Sunday, more cloud cover is going to move in by this time tomorrow morning because the humidity is going to build into the back half of the weekend's plans. Maybe a few isolated showers, not completely out of the question, to a stray rumble of thunder by tomorrow afternoon. Coverage is expected to be pretty low there. Into next week, a summer-like start. We are going to see a warming trend continue into Monday and Tuesday. We've got forecast highs in the 90s right now for here in San Antonio, but cooler weather follows for the back half of next week after we see, yes, a cold front move in early Wednesday, but also as we see rain chances increase as well. So promising news there. We'll definitely need to keep eyes on the trends here over the next several days. Right now, 56 degrees over at SA International, a dew point of 40. So there's that drier air that's moving in. That is the theme across the northern and western reaches of our area this morning. But you can see, because that front's kind of stalled just to the south of Bexar County, it is still muggy out there across our far southern and eastern counties. Gonzales, Kennedy, Pleasanton, even stretching over to Carrizo Springs, still holding on to a bit of the moisture. So because of that, in those areas, that's where we are seeing some of that patchy, dense fog develop, especially in Gonzales. Visibility is right now below 1 mile, but here in and around the San Antonio area, not really seeing any issues when it comes to hindered visibility. So that is the good news still across our southeastern counties. The coastal plains, do take it easy out there on the roads if you are stepping out early this morning. Temperature wise, again, we'll start to see those climb into the upper 70s by 11 a.m. through the lunchtime hour, low 80s here in San Antonio, and then into this afternoon. Daytime highs topping off in the mid 80s here in town, a little bit warmer the farther south and west that you go. Pleasanton around 88 degrees this afternoon, 87 in Hondo, a little bit cooler across portions of the hill country, forecast high around 83 in Comfort. Looking at the dew point trend again throughout the remainder of the day here in town, those dew points are on the lower end, but throughout the overnight hours and into our Sunday, Monday, we start to see a warm front move through. Winds shift back in from the south. More of that Gulf moisture works back into the area. So that also could spark up that isolated shower chance tomorrow morning. Even as early as this afternoon by about 4 p.m., a few very stray light showers possible. Again, coverage very limited. Notice here later on tonight and into the overnight hours, we'll start to see that front move in. There's that isolated shower activity possible tomorrow morning, especially across our southwestern counties. That then moves farther up to the north throughout the first half of the day. I think for the most part into Sunday afternoon, the better energy is going to be north and east of our area, but still we'll hold on to a bit more of the cloud cover, maybe a few peaks of sunshine by tomorrow afternoon there as well. Into next week, low to mid 90s Monday and Tuesday. Tuesday, the record is 93, so we could actually break that. And then notice by the second half of next week, better rain chances and cooler temperatures. You guys know that we need every drop of rain that we can get, so definitely fingers crossed on that.
95 in April? Crazy.
I don't know if I'm ready for that.
No. I'm excited about that front that's going to come in.
Me too. Yeah, yeah. Taste of summer is definitely
I will take rain and clouds for months on end over.
I'm the same way.
95 right. or 100 degrees. Yes. Can't even walk outside weather.
Yeah, I kind of like when it's a little bit cooler in the morning.
Yeah.
And then maybe the sun kind of peaks out a little bit as the day goes along. Just, yeah, 95, I don't know.
It's just, especially, yeah, it's early April. It's way too early for us to be doing that.
Thank you, Mia. Mm-hmm. It's 6:18, 57 degrees. Today on Texas Eats, David Elder heads to the barbecue station to try some awesome smoked brisket.
Start making this tray. What's the first thing you're gonna get?
Brisket.
All right, let's
gotta
check
have
out
brisket. Here in Texas.
We use upper choice prime briskets.
Look at that intermuscular fat that's in there.
Brisket's king, and, you know, Texas, so for sure.
I want to go in. I'm gonna grab this guy.
You want me to grab the other one?
Yeah, you're gonna grab.
Here we go.
Cheers. Wow.
Not bad, right? Might have to go a bit back in for another one.
Yeah. Super tender. Falls apart.
Okay, do you eat brisket with barbecue sauce or in a sandwich or just by itself like he just did?
Okay, so I've been told that good brisket, you should not need barbecue sauce. I try and eat it without barbecue sauce.
Okay.
But I like lean brisket, though.
Oh, no, I don't like lean brisket.
No.
I like the juice and the fat.
The ends and stuff, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, definitely. But, man, what a life there, David Elder.
Must be nice. 6:23 and 57 degrees.
All right, you may remember her from one of Netflix's hit shows, Tiger King. We all remember that. Carol Baskin is back in the spotlight again, this time for her announcement about her big cat sanctuary, what she and her husband plan on doing coming up next.
Okay, a famous big cat sanctuary is saying goodbye, at least at its current location.
All right, we all remember Carol Baskin. Well, her Florida facility featured in the Netflix show Tiger King is closing and moving now to Arkansas. Their 35 cats are moving to a sanctuary there in that state, and the land will be sold. The Baskins say the new facility has larger enclosures and the cost to keep the animals there will be less.
The proceeds from the sale will be used to fund projects to save big cat species in the wild. The Baskins say with the passage of new laws, there should be less of a need to rescue big cats. They want to change their focus to preservation and protection of the feline species.
There's a lot going on there. That's a whole scene.
It's a deep
the
dive.
Big cat scene is
down the rabbit hole.
Yeah.
Interesting if you want to spend all afternoon doing that.
Yeah, definitely. Time now is 6:27 and temperature actually went down a little bit there. 57 degrees now.
Okay, spring cleaning, it's still going on for some, and you may find old technology devices just laying around your home. Still ahead, why it may be time to get rid of them.
Happy Saturday. It is 6:30 in the morning on the first day of April. April Fool's Day.
April Fool's Day.
Yes.
I don't like April Fool's Day.
Not a fan, yeah.
I think it's silly.
Pranks, tricks.
No tricks.
Mm-mm.
No pranks.
No, definitely not.
Mia, Please don't trick us with any forecast.
Okay, fair enough. I really don't like all the pranks either. I'm like you, Sarah. I believe them too easily. So, you know, yeah. Trick me, it's easy. But yes, no tricks in terms of this forecast today. We've got lower humidity that is moving into at least the majority of South Central Texas here this Saturday morning. Still do have some lingering moisture though across the coastal plains in our far southeastern counties. But for most of us, feeling a little bit better out there this morning. 56 officially over at SA International, still holding on to the low 60s though on the south side of Bexar County over there at Stinson. It's 54 at Kelly and 55 over at Randolph there on the east side. Now, throughout the remainder of this Saturday, we are expecting relatively nice conditions, a mix of sun and clouds. Mid-70s by 10 a.m. here in San Antonio. That transitions to the low 80s into the early afternoon hours. And then for the most part, I think this afternoon, daytime highs are headed for the mid-80s here in San Antonio. Around 85 is that forecast high here this Saturday. 88 in Pleasanton, a little bit hot. The farther south and west that you go across portions of the Winter Garden, topping off at 88 in Carrizo Springs, 87 in Eagle Pass. A little bit cooler, though, across our far northwestern counties up into the Hill Country, 82 in Kerrville, 84 over in Junction. Now, throughout the remainder of today, again, for most of us, relatively drier air. That's going to make it feel pretty comfortable to step out to. But as we head into our Sunday, that's going to build a little bit more. The 90s are forecasted to return early next week, Monday and into Tuesday. Tuesday, we could potentially challenge an existing record high. But then the second half of next week is going to feature some cooler conditions after we see a front move through. That also is going to bring some higher rain chances as well. We'll get you all those details and time it out coming up in just a few, guys.
Kimia, one neighborhood in San Antonio now has safety concerns just days after a deadly crash at a busy intersection. San Antonio police say a driver died after running a red light at the corner of Hildebrand and Howard. So according to police, the pickup truck driver was going at a high rate of speed yesterday evening and crashed into another car. The Monte Vista Historical Association chair tells us the intersection is known for crashes, speeding, close calls, and screeching tires as vehicles try to come to a stop.
It's certainly not at all suitable for the amount of traffic it carries. Sometimes it's one lane, sometimes it's two lanes. Sometimes people don't know what the heck they're doing when they're driving on it.
Neighbors' concerns have made it to District 1 Councilman Mario Bravo. He says the intersection's traffic lights have been delayed for a longer buffer between red and green. Public Works plans to install a crosswalk next month, and its staff will join Bravo for a meeting with residents next week.
Crime has been up this week in San Antonio, and one local judge says gun violence and family violence has also been on the rise. Bexar County Criminal Judge Ron Rangel says that's not just a San Antonio problem or Texas problem, but he says this is a national problem as well. He explains that there are a lot of factors to the changes in crime. He adds sometimes the trend comes in cycles. Judge Rangel believes that communities and leaders are doing a better job at trying to get to the root of the problems that are leading to this rise in crime. Those roots include homelessness, hunger, lack of family support, and education.
We only have one felony mental health court and one misdemeanor mental health court. I run the felony mental health court. We don't have the space to handle all the needs that we have in Bexar County as it relates to those in the system.
And he says it's going to take more funding, not just for bigger jails, but for programs, case managers, and clinicians to be able to put a dent on the crime problem.
A Bexar County judge convicted a deputy U.S. Marshal of manslaughter. It was over an accident that happened January of 2020 along Loop 1604 and Babcock Road. Jonathan Jones was driving his pickup truck the wrong way when he crashed head-on into a sedan and killed 23-year-old Taylor McGowan. The U.S. Marshals put Jones on administrative leave after the crash. Right now, it's still up to the court to decide how long he'll spend in prison.
Assault rifles and baseball bats are part of the sales pitch that local school districts and private schools are gathering for school security. That was the sales demonstration from a company called Armored One. The CEO there showing us the strength of the company's security film and glass and demonstrating how much harder it would be for an active shooter to get into a new school campus. New Texas school safety standards are expected to take effect later this spring. They include a requirement for schools' exterior glass glass doors to be able to resist a forced entry. The Centers for Disease Control has issued a salmonella outbreak warning linked to flour. Investigators are working to identify which brands are included. As of right now, a dozen people have been reported sick across 11 states. Three of them had to be hospitalized. The CDC warns that any unbaked flour can have germs in it, like salmonella. Signs of salmonella illnesses include high fever, diarrhea, vomiting, and dehydration. And when is it time for a new car? Which is better, buying it or leasing it? Many questions that people have here. After all, prices are up and so are interest rates. 12 on Your Side's Marilyn Moritz breaks it all down to help you decide what's best for you.
When Oscar Pagan got his new Explorer, he decided to buy.
The option to own is always better, in my opinion, than to lease, because at least you have an asset, and if anything ever happens, you can sell that asset.
Buy or lease? It can be a tough decision. The average price paid for a new car now is nearly $50,000. And with interest rates more than 6%, you're likely looking at a bigger monthly payment either way. On the surface, leasing can be more appealing.
First, it's always under warranty. Second, you're always driving a car with the latest safety features. And third, if you're working part-time in the office and part-time at home, you're not driving as much. So that means you probably won't exceed the lease's limits on how many miles you can drive.
Payments are usually lower with a lease because you're not paying for the full value of the car. So you may be able to drive a more expensive car. But there's one hard fact about leasing. At the end of the term, you have to return it.
A major downside of leasing is that you have an endless cycle of paying for a car. You're never without a car payment because as soon as the one lease is up, you have to either buy a car or get into another lease.
A head-to-head comparison is difficult, but in general, two back-to-back three-year leases will always cost more compared to owning over that same period because the buyer owns an asset at the end. If you do buy, there are ways to save. Don't rely on the dealer for the best loan rate. Check your bank or credit union. And if your heart isn't set on a specific car, shop around for the manufacturer's incentives. Marilyn Moritz, KSAT 12 News.
Okay, looking ahead to some things that are happening today. The big enchilada library downtown set to reopen.
All right. I always remember this because that's where they shot some of Selena there. Mm-hmm. Where she was supposed to be in Mexico and they shot part of that movie there. So, yeah, some huge renovations here. And this comes after years of improvements. Alyssa Cole joins us now with the very latest on the Central Library.
Yes, RJ, thank you so much for teaching me that cool little fact. And I also love calling it the Big Enchilada as well. Now, that's what a lot of us know it as. It recently had a renovated first floor, and it includes a redesign of the main entrance for impaired accessibility and security. There's also a new main desk, art walk, and inclusive restroom. On the third floor, the children's library was redesigned to include a new story room, early literacy play area, flexible programming space, and computer lab for families.
Something else that we are actually going to launch on Saturday is a Learn Center. It is an adult education resource, so people can come in and get help with job hunting, interview skills, ESL, you know, things that they need to make their lives better.
You know, RJ, Sarah, when I spoke with Haley, I realized there's so much more than even just the adult center she was speaking about. They added more art gallery space because they're expanding with their local art show and the different areas around the library. It's really going to be very nice, and it's a $3 million renovation. The library also received its first fresh coat of paint in over 10 years. The indoor renovations were funded through the 2017-2022 bond program, and we have more information on our website at ksat.com.
Thank you, Alyssa. Also happening today, CPS Energy is hosting its 24th annual Kids Fish Day at Calaveras Lake. This will be a catch and release event from 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. Texas Parks and Wildlife will be donating 500 catfish to the lake. Rods, reels, and tackle boxes will be provided.
All right, there's a lot going on there. The Central Library, we got the fishing day out there. We got a barbecue cook-off that Alyssa and I are going to be at. It's going to be, a lot of fun taking place this weekend. So time now is 6:41, and we're back up to 58 degrees.
If you've been doing some spring cleaning, you may have noticed old technology devices just laying around your home. Coming up next, what will tell you why it might be time to get rid of those.
All right, I'm taking a quick look here at live cam. See, it's been a kind of a crisp start to your Saturday morning as we get ready to go today. The first day of April, Mae Montgomery is tracking the very latest weather with us. She will have that with us when we come back.
Do you have any old technology just sitting around your house collecting dust? It might be time to finally get rid of those old devices. Here's ABC's M. Nguyen on how you may even be able to make a little money off of them.
Spring is always a good time to declutter your home, like sorting through those old cell phones, tablets, and laptops that have been stowed away for a while.
I think a lot of us just have these piles of old tech collecting dust, sitting there thinking maybe someday I might need it. But no, don't let it sit there too long.
CNET's Bridget Carey says getting rid of those electronics can make space and even make you money.
Some websites will offer to pay you, or you can even go to a big box store and you'll get some cash or store credit.
You can compare best offers on websites like Declutter, Gazelle, and Amazon.
I have a really old iPhone, an iPhone 6S Plus. This thing, it is a little clunky, but it works, and I can get $20 for it. One site offered me $20. If I went to Best Buy, they'd offer me $15.
Carrie says that even items that are well past their prime can sell if you're patient.
Here's an iPad mini, came out in 2012. Apple's not giving me squat for this, but because it's in good condition and it works just fine, my kids have been using it for a while, I can make money off eBay.
And you might be surprised by what you can resell, like DVDs and CDs or a pair of used earbuds.
These are my Powerbeats Pro earbuds that have been in my ear for years now, and I could still make $25 for these things.
If selling or exchanging your tech isn't an option, Carrie suggests seeing if someone else can put it to good use.
So my kids have these old kid tablets. These things, you know, they grow out of. Find some moms at your preschool, see a Facebook group. You know, you could always find a good home for things, even if it's not a traditional piece of tech.
At the very least, recycle it at an electronics store so it doesn't end up in a landfill. And be sure to do a factory reset on your device before getting rid of it to protect your personal information. M. Nguyen, ABC News, New York.
Any old devices?
I don't think I have any laying around.
I just found some.
Like an old iPad.
Right.
I remember the first one I got freshman in high school and I was so excited. Like, oh my goodness, yeah. I'm pretty sure that I still have that one somewhere.
Yeah, we just moved and I found an old, like my very first iPhone. It was like the screen was all cracked, but I wanted to turn it on and see what I could. It was still working.
It was like this thick. They had the different chargers and everything. Yeah. I remember transitioning to the new iPhone charger. That was so hard because, you know, it was just.
It was annoying.
It was different. You had to completely redo your whole charging category. Anyways, so
maybe some people doing some spring cleaning today, maybe out and about.
Not too bad. Any outdoor chores that you may have to do as well. Today's going to be a pretty nice day for that, all things considered. We've got lower humidity that's moving in behind a front that has actually managed to make its way into a good portion of South Central Texas. So right now, behind that front, we're in the 50s, even the 40s up in Kerrville, stretching over to Fredericksburg. But on the south side of that boundary, Pleasanton, Cotulla, Kennedy, it's a little bit warmer and muggy out there waking up this Saturday morning, still in the low 70s. And when we take a look at the dew points, which is how we measure the low level moisture in the air, it is still very sticky out there across our far southern and eastern counties, especially the coastal plains. So that's where we're seeing some of that patchy fog development. So take it easy out there on the roadways across our southeastern counties if you are stepping out early this morning. I do think, though, by this afternoon, that front's going to move a little bit farther south, and we should be able to see some of that drier air take over, especially for places like Pleasanton, stretching over to Carrizo Springs, Wilson County, Karnes County there as well. So it will feel a little bit more comfortable out there later this afternoon. But notice as we head into our Sunday, especially by the early afternoon hours, that south wind is going to kick back on on. A warm front moves through and plenty of that Gulf moisture is going to return. So enjoy the drier air today because it is going to be a bit more humid out there throughout the second half of the weekend. Throughout the remainder of this Saturday, partly cloudy skies, temperatures warming into the upper 70s by 11 a.m. into the early afternoon. We see those thermometers climb into the low 80s here in San Antonio by about 4 to 5 p.m. Those daytime highs climb into the mid 80s. Around 85 is that forecast high here in town. Most of us will stay dry today, but by around 3, 4 o'clock, it's possible we find a few very isolated light showers try to develop, especially along and east of the I-35 corridor. And then maybe later this evening across our southwestern counties, another stray shower, maybe a stray rumble of thunder, not completely out of the question. Coverage is expected to be very low, though, especially today. Into tomorrow morning, this is 7 a.m., we start to see that warm front move in from the south. So a few isolated showers possible, Pleasanton, Hondo, stretching over to Uvalde first thing tomorrow morning. By the mid-morning hours here in San Antonio, we've got about a 20% chance to find a few isolated showers there as well. And then notice as we head into the early afternoon, that front moves out of our area. The better energy is off to our northeast. Still, we'll keep eyes on the radar to see if we maybe can't find an isolated shower develop there. Temperatures will start off in the low 60s here in San Antonio tomorrow morning, and then daytime highs climb into the mid to upper 80s. 90s expected Monday and Tuesday. A taste of summer is ahead. We could potentially challenge the record high of 93 there on Tuesday as well. That is ahead of our next front and higher rain chances. It'll move in by the middle of the week. You can see there's that severe weather and storm system that impacted such a large portion of the lower 48 yesterday. But this area of low pressure that is well off to our northwest this morning, that is essentially what's going to bring that next system into our area on Wednesday. And then behind that front, when you combine that with a favorable pattern for scattered to maybe even widespread showers, temperatures are going to be a lot cooler. And you'll also want to keep the umbrella handy by Thursday and Friday. So we definitely need the rain, a lot to fine tune there, but we'll definitely keep eyes on it and check back in. Thank you, Mia. You bet.
So enjoy your weekend because it's going to get a little warm.
Yes, next week's going to be, it's going to be hot for sure.
All right, time now is 6:51 and we're back there at 57 degrees.
A man skiing down a mountain discovers something sticking out of the snow. Next, the amazing footage of how one man saved another man's life as he was buried in that snow.
Welcome back to Good Morning San Antonio. We're talking about a heart-pounding rescue on Mount Baker in Washington State. A man was skiing in an isolated area on March 3rd when he spotted a snowboard upside down in the snow.
His quick reaction may have saved a life, and his GoPro camera captured it all. So Francis Zuber says he was skiing through the trees with a friend at Mount Baker when he caught a glimpse of a snowboard just sticking out of the snow right there. He started digging for a couple of minutes through that heavy snow as quickly as he could.
Okay, can you breathe? Oh, yeah, okay. All right, we're both gonna catch our breath for a sec. I'm gonna help dig you out, okay?
Thank you.
He's like, hey man, you saved a life today. Like, thank you for stopping.
Wow, the snowboarder had been buried upside down in a hazard called the tree well. There are depressions that form at the base of trees that can present a real danger for skiers.
Mm. Ooh. That's literally like finding a needle in a haystack right there.
I know.
How do you even, what are the odds of you finding that person there? But I mean, that was very fortunate that he was there to help save this person's life.
Good eye. Mm-hmm. All right, 6:56, 57 degrees. We'll be right back. All right, let's get you one final look at those current temperatures outside. A little bit cooler and even chilly across portions of the Hill Country. 42 in Kerrville, 45 in Comfort here in San Antonio. We are in the 50s and a few 60s out there. Helotes stretching over to Stinson. Today, lower humidity for most, partly cloudy skies. It's going to be a beautiful start to the weekend. Low 80s by lunchtime. Daytime highs climbing into the mid 80s here in San Antonio. A little bit warmer the farther south and west that you go. Humidity returns tomorrow. Maybe a few isolated showers, especially tomorrow morning. Monday, warmer, dare I say hotter, 93. Tuesday, 95. And then after that front moves in early Wednesday, we'll see cooler temperatures and yes, maybe some better rain chances by Thursday and Friday, guys. Don't like that 95, but I do like that cold front coming.
Yes,
in.
And those rain chances. We need it.
2 days.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, gross. Thank you, Mia.
You're welcome.
Hey, guys, we'll be back here at 8 a.m.
Live from KSAT 12, Good Morning San Antonio starts right now.
We don't know where they're going, but we hope they make them happy like they made us happy.
This morning on GMSA, San Antonians have a chance to own a piece of history. How you can get your hands on some famous items from the pig stand.
Plus, you're looking live at Mike Taylor's barbecue benefit cook-off. That's right, the self-proclaimed mayor of sports. This is all to help out the Salvation Army Boys and Girls Club. GMSA's Alyssa Cole is out there near Woodlawn Lake Park all this morning. We'll hear more from her in just a minute.
Nice weather to be out there barbecuing, as long as you have a light jacket, because it's 57 degrees right now. Mia Montgomery is in for Sarah Spivey this morning, and she'll have our weekend forecast for us.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. It is 8 o'clock on Saturday, April 1st.
April Fool's Day.
April Fool's Day. Happy April Fool's Day to everybody.
I don't like April Fool's Day.
No.
I don't like to be tricked. I don't like the jokes.
Yeah.
I don't like the fake press releases, the fake posts
yes.
or announcements
yeah.
on Instagram.
Yeah,
no.
we do get those every mm-hmm. now and then. I'll tell you what is a good day today. Is it Stephanie Sedna's birthday?
Stephanie Sedna's okay. and our photographer,
Azian
Bermina.
Yeah.
It's a great day. Happy birthday day to them. And for birthday plans, any other weekend plans, the weather is fantastic out there. Yes, it is a little cool out there this morning, especially up in the hill country. Check out Curve. 42 degrees right now, just a degree warmer off to the east in Comfort. 46 in Bandera here in Bear County. We are in the 50s and a few low 60s. 58 officially over at SA International. 55 at Converse. Since it on the south side of Bear County, waking up in the low 60s. Now, we've had a weak cool front move through the area overnight last night and into early this morning. And for most of us, especially across our western and northern counties, that has filtered in much drier air. So those dew points a lot lower right now than where we were this time yesterday. So that's why it feels a lot more comfortable to step out to early this morning. But across our southeastern counties, coastal plains region, that drier air hasn't really been able to fully take over yet. So it still is a bit more muggy, and that's also where we are seeing some reduced visibility. Some patchy fog has developed, especially over in the Seguin and Gonzales area. So we'll keep eyes on that this morning. Here in San Antonio, partly cloudy skies expected for the majority of this Saturday. Low 80s by lunchtime, mid 80s as we head into this afternoon. It is going to be a beautiful start to the weekend across South Central Texas. Maybe a very stray shower possible throughout the second half of the day. And then into Sunday, we've got a 20% chance for a few isolated showers to maybe a stray thunderstorm. Coverage is expected to be very limited with that. The biggest thing to notice here on this 3-day outlook, check out that warming trend. 90s expected Monday and into Tuesday of early next week. That all ahead, though, of another cool down and some more promising rain chances. We'll time all of this out and get you all the details coming up here in just a few minutes, guys. Thank you, Mia. Happening today, a big barbecue fundraiser right now on the city's west side.
That's right. This is Mike Taylor's barbecue benefit cook-off, and this is helping out the Salvation Army Boys and Girls Club.
That's where we find our Alyssa Cole. She's out there live near Woodlawn Lake Park. Alyssa, this fundraiser is to help those operations, right?
Yes, good morning, RJ, Sarah. It's to help with operations. You know, Mike Taylor, who puts this event on annually, he's one of our media friends over at Ticket FM 760. And when we got together, he told me he does this, you know, with people across the community, across the city. He gets together because the proceeds from this event, it goes towards equipment upgrades, computer lab upgrades, adding food to the pantry, repainting the building or inside the different classrooms inside the the Boys and Girls Club to help maintain that general upkeep. Now, what's really cool about this event is that there are 20, and we'll have the camera just come and pan over this way. Yes, Santiago is coming to join us. We have 25 teams here surrounded across this soccer field, and they're all working together and competitively in a way, cooking chicken, pork, beef, and they're all hoping to sell it out for $10 a plate so those proceeds can go to the Boys and Girls Club. And when I spoke with the Boys and Girls Club officials, they tell me this is an example of what it means to pour into San Antonio's youth.
It's a refuge for mostly kids in this neighborhood to have a place to go after school or in the summertime when they've got a lot of downtime, and kids that also need to eat three times a day, kids that need a place to be inside whenever they can. And that's what the Boys and Girls Club here on this side of town does.
Well, it's a great mission that they're on. Anywhere between 50 to 100 kids between 5 and 12 years old come here every day after school for tutoring, downtime, and maybe even sometimes for a little snack or a little meal. Now, we spoke with Salvation Army leaders, and they tell us this particular fundraising event is crucial for their operating budget because it provides that financial backing that's needed for children's summer programs and what have you. Now, if you are watching this report and you're thinking about what you're going to have for lunch today, for $10, you can have a plate of barbecue, rice, and I mean all the trimmings and all the sides. We're here at 615 Peacock on the west side. It's over by Woodlawn Lake Park, right outside of the Boys and Girls Club. There's a soccer field right across the street, so come out and join us. I'll be here, Lee will be here, RJ will be here, and we're all going to be judging food. It's just going to be a good time this Saturday morning, so we're looking forward to seeing you soon. RJ, Sarah.
Oh my God, you could already smell the good barbecue out there from all of those teams. And of course, it's for a great cause out there. Thank you very much, Alyssa. Also happening today, this is your chance to own a piece of San Antonio history.
Yeah, memorabilia from the pig stand will be auctioned off starting at 9 a.m. in the parking lot of the iconic diner on Broadway. That includes about 200 decorative pigs that once filled the diner over the past 100 years. The longtime San Antonio staple shut its doors permanently earlier this month. Owner Marianne Hill says proceeds will go to her staff.
Going to need some money in their pocket. They got their last check already. I am happy and honored to do something for them.
Hill says she closed the pig stand in March to take care of her health and spend time with her children and grandchildren.
In your morning headlines, Pope Francis has been discharged from the Rome hospital where he was being treated for bronchitis. As he left the hospital, he told reporters, quote, "I'm still alive." The Vatican says Pope Francis will be at St. Peter's Square for Palm Sunday Mass to mark the start of Holy Week.
Meanwhile, a new study suggests school-age children across the globe missed almost 4 months worth of learning due to COVID-19 pandemic. Researchers looked at data from 42 studies on learning progress during the pandemic in 15 different countries. The author of the study says students haven't fully recovered from those setbacks. Suggestions to close a learning gap include summer school or longer school year.
And Southwest Airlines has unveiled its new action plan to prevent another operational meltdown. Last December, nearly 17,000 flights were canceled and 2 million passengers got stranded over the busy holiday season. The new plan includes adding more winter equipment and staffing at airports. Southwest is also planning to invest $1.3 billion in technology updates later this year. All right, time now is 8:08 and we have crept up to 60 degrees.
Still ahead on GMSA, an elementary school with their own news studio. That's happening after the break. We're going to look at how they're getting back to work after some technical difficulties.
All right, and how about some footy here? After the break, the UIL soccer playoffs continue to roll on as we start the new month. We'll check out how some San Antonio teams are handling the competition.
60 degrees at 8:08. The sun is starting to really shine through that kind of clouds you see up there.
Yeah, see it kind of trying to peek through there.
Are we going to have any rain this weekend? And next week, it gets up to 95 degrees. Neil will let us know when we come back.
Welcome back. The third round of the UIL Class 6A girls soccer playoffs kicked off at Gustafson Stadium last night with Taft taking on Warren. In the 13th minute here, we see Bella Galan settles down a back pass, puts a shot on goal that just sneaks past the outstretched arms of the keeper there for a 1-0 lead. The Taft Raiders take this one and are heading to the regional semifinals with a 4-1 victory. All right, now to Comalander Stadium, where the Lee boys were taking on Johnson in the third round. Penalty kicks here for the Jaguars in the 66th minute. Diego Robles buries it in the back of the net. Nice shot there. Johnson then ties it with 15 minutes left in regulation, but the Vols, they answer back 4 minutes later. Substitute Lucas Saldana puts it past the keeper. Check that out. There you go, my man Lucas there. And another 2 minutes later, these were only his second and third goals of the season. Lee is heading back to the regional semifinals with a 4-1 victory.
My right winger just played me into the space and I just took off. I saw a chance and I took it. I think as a team, we really pulled through on this game and I couldn't have done it without the team.
Yeah, a lot of excitement there as Lee will now face Browns Rivera in the regional semifinals next Friday at 5 p.m.
Onto the hardwood, San Antonio Spurs are winding down their season, hoping to snap a 5-game losing streak. And they couldn't get past the Golden State Warriors while on the road. The Silver and Black lose 130-115. They play the Sacramento Kings on Sunday at 5 p.m.
Yeah, that season can't end fast enough. All right, looking ahead, the NCAA Men's Final Four, those games are tipping off later today down there in Houston. Florida Atlantic is taking on San Diego State in the first game and tipping off at 5:09 p.m. And then it's the University of Miami taking on the UConn Huskies at 7:49 p.m. And the winners of those games will face each other for the championship game on Monday night.
Isn't the women's championship game?
The women's championship game is Sunday afternoon. Yeah.
Okay.
And that, and they, Caitlin Clark, she plays with Iowa, incredible player. They beat South Carolina last night. And that, those games are being in, held in Dallas too. So a lot of Texas flair to these Final Fours.
Dallas tomorrow?
At the American Airlines.
Oh, American
Don't worry.
I'm like been reading about all the traffic nightmares because of Taylor Swift tomorrow.
Yeah, and you'll be in Arlington.
Opening weekend, weekend for the Rangers.
Yes.
It's going to be.
There's just so much going on.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I'll be asking about the Arlington forecast.
I was going to say we might need to take a trip up I-35 to get Sarah a personalized forecast for that
Thank
one. Well, I can say here, at least in San Antonio today, it is going to be absolutely beautiful. A fantastic start to the weekend across South Central Texas, thanks to the fact that we had a weak cold front move in overnight. And for most of us, not all of us, but for most of us, we have seen much drier air filter in, which means that it's just that much more comfortable to step out to early this Saturday morning. Highs for the most part warmer than average this afternoon, topping off in the mid 80s, but again those lower humidity values making it feel just a bit better. It's possible we find a very stray shower this afternoon. We'll call it about a 10% potential into Sunday morning, about a 20% potential for a few isolated showers there, and really that's because we're going to start to see the humidity build. So enjoy the comfortable feel out there today, because especially by tomorrow afternoon I think we'll start to feel a little bit more of that humidity pump back in. Into next week, it is a summer-like start. Temperatures climb into the 90s, but maybe a cooler and soggy end to the week after we see another front move in and more promising rain chances return to the forecast. So we'll talk all about it. Right now, 58 degrees officially here in San Antonio. You can see where we have that clash of dry air and more humid air, especially across our far southeastern counties. That mugginess still with us, and because of that, especially over in Gonzales, looking at you, hardly any visibility out there right now because we've seen some dense fog develop. So we'll keep eyes on those conditions across our far eastern and southeastern counties over the next few hours. I do think those conditions will improve by about 10 to 11 a.m. Here in San Antonio, though, no issues out there in terms of visibility. Partly cloudy skies will be the theme today. Temperatures warming into the low 80s into the early
afternoon hours. And then for the most part here in town, daytime highs will be climbing into the mid 80s, around 85 here in San Antonio, a little bit warmer across our far southwestern counties, 88 in Pleasanton, 87 in Hondo, and a little bit cooler across portions of the Hill Country in the low 80s this afternoon. Notice our dew point trend into Sunday. Those dew points do look to rise. So because of that, we'll see a warm front move in tomorrow morning. There, that's when that isolated chance for a few showers moves in as well. Notice here before we can get there, though, this afternoon around 3-4 o'clock, it's possible along and east of the I-35 corridor, we find a few very isolated light showers move in. And then later tonight across our southwestern counties, a few more quick splashes of rain certainly possible. Coverage is expected to be pretty limited. But here 7 a.m. tomorrow morning, we start to see that warm front move in from the south. And then that's when we could find a few isolated showers out there as well. Overall, for most of us, this weekend should be pretty dry out there. Look at next week. Low to mid 90s, potentially breaking a record high on Tuesday. If that 95 degree forecast high verifies, we'll keep eyes on that. But then notice on the backside of that next front that moves through, not just some cooler temperatures, but especially by Thursday and Friday, some better chances for rain. So a lot of details to fine tune, but we will definitely keep eyes on it and keep our fingers crossed because we need it.
We definitely need the rain. Thank you, Mia.
You bet.
It's 8:17 and 60 degrees.
And coming up before 8:30, KSAT insiders have a chance to be a royal during Fiesta. How you can win, plus a chance for some tickets, that's still ahead.
And up next, it's never too late to finish what you started. Why one woman in Ohio who's 102 years young didn't let her age stop her from getting a college degree.
Welcome back. This morning, a resident at a senior living home in Ohio is proving that it's never too late to follow your dreams. A 102-year-old or young named Nancy, woman here, accomplished a lifelong dream of receiving a college degree. She said she was thrilled to be given an honorary Associate of Public Service degree from Zane College. The honor comes just ahead of her 103rd birthday this month. And some elementary school kids in West Virginia are learning how to go after the big story.
Love this. Athens Elementary School has their very own news studio, and they're starting things up again after a long pause. They got their start in 2018, but are back after a long break from COVID-19. They cover local, national, and world news, and even do sports and weather. These student journalists also do fun segments like Joke of the Week, Interesting Fact, and Kindness Reporter.
It looks for people that do kind things, and then when I see it, I get a press pass and I go get them and I interview them.
It really makes you come out of your shell because you're in front of a camera and you're talking to the whole school. So that really helps if you have like social anxiety.
Yeah, you better get rid of the social anxiety.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you want to be a reporter. Yep. Well, in front of the camera, behind it, the kids say they're having fun. The school streams a newscast on YouTube. I love that.
Absolutely.
I wish I had something like that.
I wanted the snacks reporter. That would be my beat.
I'm the snacks reporter.
Just trying all the different snacks there for the kids. All right, guys, 8:23 this Saturday morning and 60 degrees out there.
Up next, it's almost time for Fiesta, how you can live like royalty and have your own court this year as a KSAT insider.
Fiesta is almost here, and KSAT is kicking that off with a KSAT Insider contest. This is really cool. KSAT Insiders now have a chance to be a royal for a day. This will give you the opportunity to ride in the Battle Flowers Parade with your own court and get some extra prizes. And we have all that information on your screen right now. Head over to KSAT.com for more.
Being a royal is all about in your heart, right?
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
In my heart, I'm a princess. Every day.
You are. Definitely, Sarah.
It's 8:26 and 61 degrees.
All right. Still ahead at 8:30. The Big Enchilada Library. That's right. That iconic library downtown will be reopened today after years of improvements. We got a preview coming up next.
You're looking live at Mike Taylor's Barbecue Benefit Cook-Off that's going to help out the Salvation Army Boys and Girls Club. GMSA reporter Alyssa Cole is out there now near Woodlawn Lake Park. She'll be out there all morning. We're going to hear from her in just a bit.
Good morning. Welcome to Good Morning San Antonio. It is 8:30 on your Saturday, April 1st.
Happy April 1st. I'm not going to say Fool's Day.
Don't do it.
Don't
trigger
me. Don't fool me. Yeah. Mia, I know you would never fool me with the weather.
I would not. I will definitely give you the truth straight up. And here's the truth. No April Fool's joke in terms of the forecast today, because yes, it is going to be a very nice Saturday here in San Antonio after we had that weak front move in overnight. That drier air is in place for most of us. Still a little bit more muggy across our far southeastern counties where that drier air hasn't been able to fully take over just yet. But here in San Antonio, waking up, stepping outside for Saturday morning plans, it feels pretty nice out there. Temperatures are in the 50s, a few low 60s, especially over at Kelly and stretching over to Stinson. Now, most of us are quiet in terms of any rain activity, and that's going to be the theme for most of us throughout the weekend. But something that I've been keeping my eye on over the past 45 minutes or so, we've had a few pretty healthy downpours and even a few isolated rumbles of thunder develop in northern Mexico there near the Rio Grande, and that is working its way farther up to the northeast in and around the Eagle Pass area there in Maverick County. So we'll keep eyes on that as it does try to survive the journey here into portions of Maverick County. I'll keep eyes on the radar, but again, for most of us, we are expected to stay dry throughout the remainder of this Saturday. We'll put a 10% chance in here in San Antonio later this afternoon and into the evening hours for maybe a stray light shower, but that's about it. Enjoy today because yes, that drier air is in place here in town. Temperatures will be warming into the mid 80s. Tomorrow, the humidity is going to build back into south central Texas. You'll notice that especially by tomorrow afternoon. Highs are topping off in the mid to upper 80s for your Sunday. Early next week, though, that warming trend continues. We're in the low 90s Monday, mid 90s on Tuesday, and then we're cooler with more better rain chances into the back half of next week. We'll get you all those details coming up in just a few, guys.
Mia, thank you. A neighborhood in San Antonio has safety concerns. Just days after a deadly crash at a busy intersection, San Antonio police say a driver died after running a red light at the corner of Hildebrand and Howard. That's on the city's north side. SAPD says a pickup truck driver was going too fast Friday night and crashed into another car. Peter Hulg, the Monte Vista Historical Association, tells us the intersection is known for crashes, speeding, close calls, and screeching tires as vehicles try to stop.
It's certainly not at all suitable for the amount of traffic it carries. Sometimes it's one lane, sometimes it's two lanes. Sometimes people don't know what the heck they're doing when they're driving on it.
Neighbors' concerns have made it to District 1 Councilman Mario Bravo. He says the intersection's traffic lights, they have been delayed for a longer buffer between red and green lights. Public Works plans to install a crosswalk next month, and its staff will join Bravo for a meeting with residents next week.
Crime has been up this week in San Antonio, and one local judge says gun violence and family violence is also rising. Bexar County Criminal Judge Ron Rangel says it's not just a San Antonio or Texas problem. This is a national problem as well. He says there's a lot of reasons for the changes in crime, and sometimes the trends just come in cycles. Judge Rangel believes communities and leaders are doing a better job at trying to get to the root of the problems leading to this rise of crime. Those problems include homelessness, hunger, lack of family support, and education.
We only have one felony mental health court and one misdemeanor mental health court. I run the felony mental health court. We don't have the space to handle all the needs that we have in Bexar County as it relates to those in the system.
And he says it's going to take more funding, not just for bigger jails, but for programs, case managers, and clinicians to put a dent into the crime problem.
Happening today, a big barbecue fundraiser right now on the city's west side.
That's right. Mike Taylor's barbecue benefit cook-off is helping out the Salvation Army's Boys and Girls Club.
Alyssa Cole, she's live out there now near Woodlawn Lake Park. Alyssa, how does everything look out there, or should I say smell out there?
Good morning. Let me tell you all, it smells absolutely delicious. So if you're hungry, I mean, you are probably even more hungry after smelling the great aromas of that chicken, beef, and pork. But let me tell you, we are just looking forward to what's happening here today. I will be joined by the Salvation Army's public manager, Brad Mahar, and he's going to tell us, you know, a little bit of the purpose behind this barbecue that's benefiting the Salvation Army's Boys and Girls Club. Good morning, Brad.
Hey, good morning, Alyssa.
Yes, thank you so much for joining us. So we know you all are selling the plates for $10. You all are inviting people to come out and enjoy the event experience on the field for $25. But let's talk about how these proceeds are going to directly impact the boys and girls here at the organization.
Yeah, all the proceeds raised today benefit the Peacock Boys and Girls Club, operated by the Salvation Army. We have after school programs. We have nearly 100 kids every day that come after school that have a safe place to go and get tutoring and engage in different activities. And then we also have scholarship opportunities, summer camps. So you're really helping out a lot of great local kids by supporting this event.
Perfect. And you know what? I'm going to throw you an extra question here. What happens when we all take an active role in investing in our youth here in San Antonio?
That's great. It's just that sense of ownership, that pride that you're making a difference right here in your own community. As you'll see by the people that attend today, the people that are judging, we have people that come from all walks of life, and that's reflective of who the Salvation Army serves. So this is, you know, just a great day to be here.
Thank you so much, Brad. I'll go ahead and wrap it up. Everyone watching this, we're excited that you're watching this. We're excited you're joining us. $10 for a drive-through plate and $25 for the experience. You get a t-shirt, you get to sample food, and of course, you get some of this delicious barbecue. We are here at 615 Peacock Street, right outside of the Boys and Girls Club for the Salvation Army. So feel free to join us. We'll send it back to you all.
Thank you, Alyssa. Also happening today, the Big Enchilada Library downtown will reopen after years of improvements. The Central Library has a newly renovated first floor. It includes a redesign of the main entrance for improved accessibility and security. There is also a new main desk, art walk, and inclusive restroom. On the third floor, the Children's Library was redesigned to include a new story room, early literacy, play area, flexible programming space, and computer lab for families. With a $3 million renovation, the library also received its first fresh coat of paint in over 10 years. The indoor renovations were funded through the 2017-2022 bond program. The reopening events start today at 10 a.m.
And of course, they filmed part of Selena there
Yeah. Now I see it.
The scene there, soy muy excited where she talks.
Yeah.
All right, time now is 8:38 on your Saturday morning, and we've gotten up to 61 degrees.
I'm muy excited about this. Still ahead, David Elder headed to Austin for some top-tier Texas barbecue, the preview of a brand new episode of Texas Eats that's coming up.
And after the break, Disney on Ice is back this weekend at the Alamo Dome. What families can expect to see in just a few moments.
61 degrees at 8:31 this morning. That sun's starting to peep through for that barbecue later. Mia Montgomery will have our weekend forecast when we come back.
Welcome back. This morning, your favorite Disney characters are coming to life, and you can see them live right here in the Alamo City.
SA Live's Mike and Fiona hit the ice for a sneak peek at the magical show at the Alamo Dome happening this weekend.
Two of Disney's favorite movies are going to be on the ice here at the Alamo Dome, and we are here to preview Disney on Ice presents Frozen and Encanto.
And joining us right now, a couple of the skaters in the show, Sydney Koshek and Lyra Kultus. Good afternoon, ladies. All right, tell us all about it. I mean, it's so cool to be here on the ice that you guys are skating on.
Yeah, so this week we're in San Antonio, premiering Frozen and Encanto. This is Disney on Ice's newest ice show, and it has both Frozen in Act 1 and Encanto in Act 2.
So the best of both worlds.
Yes. Okay, and so is there any part of the show that really just wows the audience? What gets the reactions?
Well, I would have to say, with Encanto being so new and a fan favorite, the Encanto segment, every little bit of it loves the excitement and the fans just sing along to all the songs.
You can just hear them, you know, they go,
as a performer, when you're getting that from the audience and you see all the little faces out there, that just must really make it extra special, right?
It is the best. Sometimes when we're out on the ice, the audience is singing so loud, we can't hear the soundtrack. It is insane. You get chills and you can just feel the energy like vibrating off of the audience.
And you're not only just skating out here, I mean, you're dancing, right? And of course, what's happening behind us right now?
So here we have Lyra demonstrating globe juggling. In the ice show, you can see our Encanto character, Luisa, juggling the globe and feeling the pressure of, you know, being the strongest in the family.
And when it comes to Frozen, because that's been around now for years, and I mean, is still so popular.
People just can't let it go.
Exactly. You just took the line out. Because you two were probably just little girls when you first saw that movie, right?
Yeah. I remember when Frozen came out, and as I was, you know, training and skating at the time, it was a dream to skate to any of the songs from Frozen, because obviously Elsa is the queen of ice. And we are ice skaters, so yeah.
And speaking of ice skaters, I mean, tell us a little bit about your ice skating background.
So I've been skating for about 10 years. I started training in Massachusetts, where I'm from, and I have dreamed about being on Disney on Ice ever since I saw my first show in probably 2010.
A dream is a wish your heart is.
She sings Butterbean. Too, but you didn't know that. So, all right,
look,
show
at that.
Is tonight. Tonight, don't slip there. Tonight through the weekend, right?
Yes, and you can get tickets at DisneyOnIce.com.
Okay, all right, and we're gonna get a little demo. We'll do the whole globe juggling thing here. So, ladies, take it away.
I'm only going this way.
I knew that was.
One of the skaters in this number, and we're kind of like the imagination and powers blooming off of Isabella. So
that's where your motivation is coming from. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're gonna have them out like this, and let's go up, down, down, up, down, down, up.
Wait, my blossom got tangled.
There you go. Nice. Up, down,
down, down, up, down, down, up.
Nice.
Down. Oh, he's moving.
Look at this. I feel like a butterfly that's escaped my cocoon.
There we go. Oh,
boom.
Awesome. 5, 6, 7.
Okay, watching this, it's like, who doesn't belong? Mike. Fiona looks like great. She's so graceful
I would have
doing
like
that.
Three times
yeah,
already.
No, I can definitely point out the guy in the back.
Yeah, no, I'd be on the ice there.
Well, hey, SA Live, it airs weekdays at 1 p.m. on KSAT 12. You can check out this story, recipes, and more on their YouTube page. Mia.
I can't get over that.
I know, Mike.
You did a great job, Mike. You did a great job.
He's like, just keep your balance.
Yes, just don't fall. Whatever you do, don't fall over.
All right.
They did
so
a good job.
Obviously, people are going to be out and about there, Alamo Dome, but a lot of different things going on. Weather?
Yes.
How's it looking?
Weather-wise, pretty good. I will say we just got the pollen count in today, though, and oak is once again probably giving a lot of us some issues this morning in the very high category. Other than that, molds, mulberry, and pecan, they're out there, but they are low today. So oak allergy sufferers, again, probably seeing some of those issues out there this morning. Temperature-wise, a little bit cool, especially the farther north and west that you go. Here in San Antonio this hour, we are sitting at 58 degrees, warmer the farther south that you travel. That front hasn't fully been able to move that far south. 65 in Pleasanton, 71 in Kennedy. 73 down in Cotulla. You can also see where we still have that muggy air in place, especially across our southern and eastern counties. But I do think here over the next few hours into the early afternoon, we should be able to see some of that drier air take over, at least for most of us. Maybe still a little humid out there in Beeville and Cotulla, but we will keep eyes on that. Enjoy the drier air today, because you can see here heading into Sunday, already by the early afternoon, those
those south winds kick back on and more of that Gulf moisture is quickly going to move back into the area. So you will notice more of that sticky feel yet again, especially throughout the second half of our Sunday. But before we can get there, the remainder of the Saturday looking fantastic here in San Antonio. Partly cloudy skies are around 74 by 10 a.m. Low 80s as we head into the lunchtime hour. And then into the afternoon, still a mixture of sun and clouds, but temperatures are topping off in the mid 80s, around 85 here in San Antonio. Again, by about 3-4 o'clock, we'll monitor for a very isolated shower along and east of I-35. And then later tonight, this is around 9 to 10 p.m., a few more isolated showers possible across our southwestern counties. Then as we head into early Sunday, this warm front moves in from the south by 7 a.m., a few isolated showers possible near Uvalde, Hondo, stretching over to Pearsall, and then in San Antonio through the mid to late morning hours. We'll monitor for maybe a few isolated showers out there as well. Generally a bit more quiet as we head into Sunday afternoon. More cloud cover tomorrow morning, and then a few peaks of sun into Sunday afternoon plans. Temperatures starting off in the low 60s. Afternoon highs head for the mid to upper 80s. Now into next week, check out that temperature trend. Monday, we're in the low 90s. Tuesday, we're in the mid 90s. In fact, the record high, existing record high on Tuesday, is 93. So if that 95 verifies, very well could break that record. And then we'll see another front move in into early Wednesday. More favorable chances for rain by Thursday and Friday. So fingers crossed, and definitely check back in as we fine tune those details over the next few days, guys. Okay. Thank you so much, Mia. It's 849 and 63 degrees.
And just ahead, if you're hungry for some barbecue, sounds delicious. You don't want to miss today's brand new episode of Texas Eats. David Elder is in Austin with the preview coming up next.
I want to talk about the brisket. It's the king of barbecue here right in Texas. So talk to me about your preparation on there and what makes it stand out.
Our preparation is just pretty simple. It's just salt and pepper, a little garlic. It's not hot and fast, but it's not low and slow. It's, you know, in between. We use an all-natural brisket. There's no hormones, grass-fed, little happy cows.
Holds up on its own weight, and I can already tell. It pulls apart. Cheers to you.
Cheers.
That's the brisket. The real deal. Great
job. See, you don't need barbecue sauce with that brisket.
It looks definitely not.
Juicy enough.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Good brisket doesn't require barbecue sauce.
Thank you, RJ.
Go with them.
It's 854 and 64 degrees.
All right, up next, a curious 5-year-old becomes a big spender online. Oh no, that just sounds like trouble. This is with help from Amazon and mom's phone. Okay, we'll explain right before 9. Welcome back. This morning, a Massachusetts mom got a big surprise. Yeesh. When thousands of dollars worth of Amazon packages started arriving on her doorstep earlier this week.
Terrifying. The culprit, a feisty 5-year-old who had monetary access to mom's phone. 5-year-old Lila ordered 5 pink motorcycles, 5 blue motorcycles, wow, in case the other 5 pink ones weren't enough, 10 pairs of cowgirl boots, and a Jeep. That comes out to over $3,000 worth of goodies. And her mom, Jessica, didn't have a clue. Jessica says she remembers giving Lila her phone to play some games in the car, but instead of a punishment, Jessica is using this as a teachable moment for her daughter. Mm. Wait, so is she returning?
I would imagine so.
Oh, she
like
is.
She is returning,
okay,
all those, yes.
She is returning.
Unless she just needs 10 bikes.
I love how she's like 5 pink ones and 5 blue ones.
Yeah. Hey, you know, there you go. Lila's got it. She's getting maybe some for
ones.
Her buddies or siblings. All right, time now is 8:57, getting closer to 9 o'clock here, and temperature is 63 degrees.
Still ahead at 9. It's been 28 years since Selena, the Queen of Tejano, has passed away. We'll hear from her family and why they believe the icon is still being remembered today.